Disclaimer, this podcast was recorded in April 2021.
Hey everyone, we are the Titos of the world. I'm Akoy Koy.
I'm Jericho.
Hey, I'm BP.
I'm Nolan.
And this is the Titos of the World Presents, the podcast. So this week we are presenting someone that we absolutely adore. Such an amazing actress and a truly beautiful soul.
And she's Ate fucking Judit. Funny.
Yeah. Oh my. Ate Judit. Adrienne Vergara. Yeah. Oh wait, there's another one. There's another one. Kimberly May. Yeah.
Kimberly May.
And I was going to say, and she is my spirit person. So Ate Judit is spirit too.
Charot.
This is what I'm gonna say. I'm gonna be biased. This is my favorite episode of all from season one.
Well, she's one of those. To be honest with you guys, you saw my reaction when she came in. That's my
guess. Just that.
Like, I never panicked before. So
you guys will hear it. It was funny. But also, oh, she is so hilarious. And
she is.
It's just special. I never had so much fun editing because I kept on having to pause because I can't concentrate because I'm laughing.
That's why I told you to edit this, because I'm not going to end up finishing it.
Well, if you think about it, it was just what? 2 hours, right? You said, how long was it? 2 hours?
We recorded for about an hour and 45 minutes.
Almost, wow. 2 hours. And then when we stopped recording...
Yep.
Oh, yeah.
It was
another hour, I think.
Yeah, well, no, we spent quite some time with her almost. Yeah,
that was 2 hours. Like, yeah. So literally we spent like 4 hours.
Basically, it was so wonderful. She's wonderful. It was just, it was a lot of color.
Yeah, and also the way the conversation just flowed. The flow of conversation that we did with her, it was like, and we were like,
and think about this. We filmed this like back in April. Like
April, yeah, right.
When we were like doing like the initial, interviews and all that.
She's technically our second interview, right?
What's it?
I think she's our third.
Third.
Yeah.
We were still trying to get our bearings with the podcast.
Exactly. This interview took place a month before the podcast came out.
Mm. Right.
Yeah.
Two, 3 weeks before the podcast was even announced, we already had this interview done. Mm-hmm. And
find the correct date.
Mind blown.
And the way that we told her that she's gonna be our season finale. She was like,
I stay true to my word. I said to her, "You are the season finale." As simple as that.
25th of April.
Oh wow.
We did this.
So literally, that was almost three months ago.
Next weekend is literally 3 months.
Three months. Yeah.
It was a wonderful Sunday morning for me. It was just wonderful.
It was a very late.
It was a very late night.
It was a late night for me and BP. Yeah.
I remember I got hungry while we were talking and I turned off my camera to eat.
I remember that. You literally turned
off your camera. I ate like this. And after a while I was like, let me not hide. Let me just switch off my camera. It'll be easier. But what? You don't want to miss out. We had such a good conversation with her. As you guys.
The tea.
Listen. What I love, especially, is that we got some tea that only came out later to the public.
Mm-hmm.
And when it finally came out, I was like, oh my god, I knew about this.
Yeah. Yep. We knew it, like, yeah. Dude, I'm just realizing it, like, now. Like, months before it was available for the public, we already knew about it.
And we kept it secret.
Oh, God. Oh. The way that I was trying not
that to part.
Speak about that, that was hard.
Oh, my God. Kimberly May.
Kimberly May. Such a special soul. An alien, one would say. Well, Kimberly May would say.
That.
Yeah.
I just love her. So here we go, everyone. Titos of the World presents Miss Adrienne Vergara. Yeah.
Hi.
Hello.
Oh my god!
Oh my god, I can't believe I'm talking to you right now.
Oh my god.
My oxygen level is gone. I'm like this.
It's so different from like not
what? Relax.
My head the imagination in my head was different from this. I'm like, oh, I can't believe you're real.
Hi. How are you?
I'm really good. Thank you.
I can't believe I'm interacting with you.
Wait, I'm so red right now.
Oh, Lord. We're all
get it together, guys. Please.
Oh, yeah. Wait, I'm sweating.
Why?
Because we love you. We love you.
It's the fan for me.
Oh, by the way, my name is VP.
Hi, VP.
Nice
to
meet you.
Oh my god.
I'm Nolan. Nice to meet you.
Hello.
And
hi, I'm me.
Oh my gosh, y'all. Would you like to introduce yourself?
Yes, I'm Jericho, and the people refer to me as Ate Judit Espiritu.
Why?
Because you're my spirit person. You are.
I put it here, Kimberly May. How do I renew?
Quiz. How do we rename?
I don't know.
Oh, you have
to go. It's just gonna be a podcast, Ate. It's not.
That's fine. It's fine.
Okay. I usually use that name on Zoom. Kimberly, me, and then they will be like, oh, who's this?
Right? It's like, wait, someone's joining, Kimberly May. Who?
I'm like, yeah. When I saw it, I was like, who's this?
And then the camera went on. It's like, wait, it's her.
I got kicked out one time.
Oh, because you're using the name?
No.
How dare they? How dare
whoever
they?
Whoever did that, tell us, because we're going to hunt them.
Yes.
You're coming.
As if they know, no.
They should know.
How dare they?
They should know it's you.
I'm so happy.
How do we start this?
I don't know. Fanboy. I'm in the presence of a goddess, you know.
Wow.
Yes, no.
You don't really.
It's true.
You don't know. You don't know.
You have no idea. No idea.
We just finished premiering our rewatching the 1, 2, and 3 episode.
So it's still fresh. Everything is
still fresh. Yeah, it's still very fresh.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Guys,
Okay, probably I'll probably start.
Yeah,
the time is ticking. I'll start it with who is Adrienne Vergara outside of show business?
Ah, okay. Actually, she's a lost alien who. Shut up.
What? I want to be a lost alien now.
Is that on track? I want to be a lost alien too.
Yeah. Okay.
I have no idea why I'm here. First and foremost, I'm an artist. So I'm doing theater and also, I don't know, we're not theater group, right? No, we're a performance company and we do performances with the communities. And yeah, that's me outside the show business. Actually, I don't consider myself, you know, big part of, I'm not a celebrity.
We do. Not with these people.
You are
not with us four.
If I see you in person, I would probably freeze, and then I'm gonna ask my
like, what happened to, right now?
Yeah, right now, definitely. Right, mm-hmm. Right.
Actually, I'm not sure if you've watched Bliss, the film. So one time I was in Katipunan. There's this restaurant. And I went there, and then there's a group, a bunch of students from Ateneo. They were like, Lilibeth! And then they all screamed and ran.
As they should. As they should.
I would probably
they
like.
Freeze.
They said,
I would freeze.
The honest level two. I'll just be like,
Okay. Because we know you from the great GSP or Gaya Sa Pelikula. That's our favorite BL, and we really love you there, you know. And my question is, when did you start acting? Why acting? Like, what inspired you to be an actor?
Actually, I formally started doing acting when I got in the Philippine High School for the Arts. And you know, when we were in school, we used to do class recording or group performances to the class. So I think that's where my acting talent came from. But actually, I was classically trained in theater in high school. So my mentor in acting is actually Charmaine Buencamino, if you know her.
Oh my god.
Yes. And she's also she also came from the same school. She's a theater arts major also. And then I pursued theater in UP Diliman. And that's it. I fell in love with acting. I'm not sure.
That's a very nice, just a good journey to go on. Discovering it like that. We mentioned GSP, the iconic GSP. And that's where I got introduced to you as the non-Filipino of this group.
Hello.
Yeah, so you're talking in English right now.
Nolan is from South Africa, so.
Okay, I'm about to have a nosebleed. It's too early. It's too early for English.
If you feel like you want to slip into Tagalog, it's quite fine.
Yeah,
he's actually more fluent than most of us.
No. They will assist me.
I wanted to tell you more stories, but yeah. But then
we'll find a way for me to understand.
We'll just
Google is a good friend of mine.
Right.
I love Google. But no, I wanted to know, how did you get the role of Ate Judit?
Oh, actually, it was the writer, and he asked me. Actually, it's in ano pala. It's in my messenger, and I want you to play the role of the sister of one of the leads. I go, sure. And
not even reading any script. Yeah, go.
Yeah, I haven't read the script. The script.
You see, this is why we love you. This is why we love you. This is why we love you.
This is what I miss Will from Bandao session.
Right. Yes. 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 Oh my god. Yes. That is iconic.
So but then it was still it was Judith with an H that time. He sent me the script and then I was like, go game. When is the shoot? Go. And actually it was cancelled. It was postponed. The shoot was postponed. And eventually we get to shoot. And it was the Judit with no H. With no H. It's what's happening to me?
What's happening?
What's happening? Are you kapang pangan, Adrienne?
What's happening?
I'm gonna have so much fun editing this episode. That was so much fun.
Good luck.
Okay, because we've been rehearsing the Filipino play, and it's a period play with deep Tagalog. So, I think I'm not used to speaking in English right now. So sorry. What am I saying?
Wala some good English.
The English well is shallow.
Oh my god. No, you were talking about the show when it was postponed or something like that.
The shoot was moved to a later date. And it was not until my one day before my shooting day. They were already there in the venue. But one day before my shooting day, that's when Gege and JP chatted with me and say, okay, let's remove the H. Okay, can I and then I and asked them, can I add some accents? So the Judit would be Judith. And then that's the only time. Okay, let's try that.
Perfect. Perfect.
I remember the time when we had our script reading online. We had the script reading via Zoom. I still have no accents yet that time, I remember. But that's also the first time I saw Ian and Paolo together in one frame.
And then somebody's turning red.
Somebody just is turning
mention,
red.
By the mention of that name, somebody's turning red.
Nagpuputla na.
Yeah, and then they're smelling each other. I was like, what? I was screaming the whole time. The whole screaming. Wow. I was like, why are they like that?
Oh, somebody left.
No, somebody left. Somebody left. Somebody left.
They're like,
gosh,
the
tea.
Mark,
are you so okay?
Are you
I'm okay.
Do you have an oxygen tank next to you?
Open the window. Open the window. Breathe.
Open the window.
It's too cold.
Yeah, I remember Gege and JP told me like, oh, you're the target market of the show.
The target.
Because I was like, ah! Why are they so close?
I think at that moment they knew we nailed it.
Yeah, we nailed it.
Yeah. We nailed it.
They actually found the best sister. So that's why it was you. Like, so perfect.
Best audience.
Yeah. Yeah. Yep.
Yeah. Well, speaking of, so fan girly of the band fan. Oh.
Yeah. Well, speaking of accents, so I was enamored by the way that your character was like created. How did you come up with the accents, and what are those accents?
Actually, in the original script, the only foreign language included there is Italian. The Italian words, Italian phrases, and the kapkun ka, that phrase. So I was, while studying my character, if she's well traveled, you know what? I know a person. I have some friends who's so well traveled, and then her accent like changes. Her pala, his accent changes every time, depending on her on his mood. So I was like, let me try. So I tried the Australian accent and some Japanese and some French.
I love it. I love every single it's funny because it's a different personality with each different accent. That's why I love
it. Very different,
I know as actor, like, you're also creating your character, so that's why you're also a co-creator of the character. So how my I always ask myself, like, how would this character be unique, and it's someone that you haven't seen yet, because there are a lot of supporting characters that are the elder sister, the best friend, the cousin, and most of the time it's the same. It has a stereotype already, like the bubbly and the so I needed to tweak something to her.
And to make her unique. Judit is very unique.
very unique and complex person, definitely.
Yes. that's why she's my spirit person. That's why she's my spirit person.
Right.
Can you do a reenactment?
Oh my gosh.
Jericho.
Jericho. No.
too much pressure. I might pass out.
I'll give you 5 minutes to internalize. Well,
where is your oxygen tank?
Where's my script? Where's my script?
Script.
Where's my script?
I think my favorite thing that you said one time, like, when it comes to like your accents, is like when you're speaking French, très bien, you know, those kind of stuff.
Ate Judit.
Judit. Without the Judit.
And it's funny because I'm not actually that fluent in French. I only took basic classes back in college because it's required. And you have to choose, you have the option to choose which foreign language. So, but I remember I stopped learning French because I hate it.
You know what's funny? You took French, I took French. I took French
really?
For 4 years. Yes.
Yeah. Wow. Yeah. The conjugations, my God, my grade.
Yeah, there's so many. So, yeah, I couldn't.
And it all sounded the same, but the spelling, like, why are you...
I got it.
It's so hard in English. Okay.
Okay.
Okay, next.
Okay, next.
I think say something.
No, you can. No,
you can. Go ahead.
Yeah, you can. Go ahead.
Yeah, you can.
We could translate it to Nolan.
Yeah.
No,
yeah, you can. No.
Maarte! Ang arte-arte ng French! Yun lang.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, okay. Yeah. French is,
I don't know how to
do you say maarte in English?
Maarte. It's mapala po. Paano?
Let's just say it's very hard.
That's what I said.
Well, I think it's very okay. So it's very over dramatic, and it's very
very
at the same
time ornate.
Yeah.
With all the so many unnecessary letters.
Napaka OA yung ano French, napaka OA.
That part.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Overacting.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, there's so many they're not needed. Some letters, it's so pam pam.
I'm dead.
I got
what's pam pam in English? Kidding.
Oh,
that I'm not sure. I can't translate that to English.
Okay, so we're talking about our favorite, one of our favorite characters in the show, right? Ate Judit. So, is there any similarities between you and Ate Judit?
I think it's for the allyship part. Because all this time, because I grew up. When I grew up with my mom's bisexual, and she's been with her partner for almost 30 years.
Ooh, wow!
Yeah, so and I thought I was a good ally. I thought I was the best ally when I was younger, and then it hit me. The show really hit me. So wait. For the first few episodes, I was actually agreeing with Ate Judit with all her placards, you know, the usual phrases. Yeah. And then at some point, I remember asking Gege about this, and she's actually a fake ally. So what does it like? So wait. Am I a fake ally too? Because I reflected so much with, I thought I was doing my best as an ally, but actually it was doing more harm than good. Yeah. Like, for instance, I had lots of gay friends who I outed. And oh, wow. I thought I was being an ally for doing that.
Oh, yeah. Okay.
So
and I can understand why.
Yeah, I can see what you're saying. Yeah.
And I grew up, you know, with the 1990s humor type of, you know, so everything is so politically incorrect, and I grew up with that. So, yeah, with the show and while studying, it was like, oh no. I'm so sorry.
Then you realize it, huh? Yeah.
Yeah, and then they had me hosted the Just Ally thing. So I was like, really? Okay. Well, at least it's educational for me and for us.
Yeah.
And even with the producers also, who is also a cis female, and she was like, I think we need this show because at least we're also learning from it.
Yeah.
So yeah, I think that's a major similarity. The rest, nah.
Not even
no, else. No, I like it there. I like what you said. I think also when you and when your character and Ian's character were having dinner on the table, you know, when he said, "Oh, that's very rich coming from you," you know, and we totally agree what you said. That I'm still learning. I didn't know what I knew back then. You know, so most people are like that. Even in the community as well, we don't really know exactly.
Yeah.
So it's evolving, and we're learning from it. As long as we're talking about it, and you know, some people like you bringing it out there with the platform, then everybody can learn.
Yeah, and I was the type of girl that when I see a trans woman, I would say, "Oh my God, you're much prettier than me. How come?" I used to be like that.
Microaggressions, yeah.
But I thought I was complimenting her.
Yeah.
But
yeah.
Those stuff. Yeah. So as a perfect ally, yeah.
I think in general though, there's no perfect ally because everybody's learning still. You know, as long as you're, you know, as long as you're trying to learn and changing from that, I guess.
That's and you also, you always come from a place of compassion and respect. Yeah.
Right. Definitely.
kaya pa. Okay. You spoke about Gege earlier. So if you were Gege, what ending would you give for Gaya Sa Pelikula season 1? I'm claiming it there's season 2. I'm claiming it. What would you have given season 1 ending for
Gaya Sa Pelikula?
It's always the alternate ending in episode 8.
That's the best ending.
And in a perfect world, that exists, right? Yeah. But we're not in a perfect world. And if we end there, there's no season 2.
That part, yeah.
They could be. They could be happy.
Yeah.
I just struggles either. Of them being together, living life together.
Domesticated.
Not us giving the plot for next season.
No, you know what, Adrienne, Makoykoy, when that scene came out, Makoykoy doesn't want to hear the song.
It's very difficult to listen.
He's been trying to sing it every time.
Yeah.
And we have a karaoke thing before, and every time I try to sing it, he was like, "How dare you? Don't sing that song."
Actually, I've only watched it once, the episode 8, because I couldn't think.
Yeah.
It's so painful.
We've watched it twice now because we just did our rewatch. I mean, we can't skip 7 and 8.
Yeah.
As much
if
as
only
I could
end on episode 6.
all this time, I've been watching 1 to 6 and always skipping 7 and 8.
Stopping there.
I stopped there. Like, I mean, I've watched the series so many times, but I don't have the courage to watch 7 and 8.
Me too.
That alternate ending. Okay.
Oh, but you know what? My very first scene with Pam Pam is on episode 7.
Oh.
Ernie and Bert scene. That's the first time.
The swimming pool.
Yeah. And it's the first time that they heard the accent. So they were. Oh. So you can see the reaction, like, and Ian was like, he wanted to laugh. No?
Well, now we know.
How did I not see that?
Me too. We should rewatch. Rewatch.
If you could observe the energy between us are still a bit awkward. I don't know.
Off. Yeah.
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 And then after that scene, we jumped to the episode 1. So yeah.
Okay.
Interesting. You mentioned ally things and the journey that you went on. How do you now define a good ally? Not a perfect ally, as it doesn't exist. Just a good ally.
Okay. So yeah, always. As I've said earlier, as an ally, you have to come from a place of compassion, of empathy, and respect, and how to... Okay, this one, I learned this last year, and it's not just with the LGBTQ community, but also with the indigenous community, with all of the those who are part of the minority groups, that if you want to be an ally, give the microphone to them.
Yeah,
or you have to share the platform with them and not just you doing all the talk and stuff, because it's because for the longest time we have to let their voices be heard and share it to them.
Yeah,
because there's but this one, actually, this is really weird that I'm using the them and they. It's like othering, so I'm still not sure how to,
we're
to
still,
use the terms.
Yeah. We're still learning too. So yeah.
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 So, but yeah, they've been silenced for the longest time. So it's time to let it all out. But and I think it's the same with Ate Judit. It's not about you. It's not always about you.
It's about them. Yeah.
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 And it's weird. Okay. I'm using them because it's all.
No, it's fine. No, that's fine.
Yeah. No, it's fine. Yeah.
It's fine. It's very fine. Fine. Yeah. Because you're referring to a community, so it's them. It's fine. Yeah.
Yeah. Okay.
Yeah.
Thank you. No, it's interesting.
Yeah. Oh, go, Jericho.
Oh, no, I was going to say it's interesting because you mentioned Ate Judit, and I was going to ask you, what advice were you going to give Ate Judit to become a better ally? But you've kind of answered the question already. Yeah. Which is really great, because I think it's definitely using your platform and then letting them or they speak on what their issues is about, or how they stand, and what, you know.
And actually, that part I've learned from a fan. And it was after the episode 1 or 2, and then someone sent me a DM, and she was the one who told me about the sharing of the microphone. And it's like, oh, so yeah, I'm actually learning from the fans also. So thank you for this.
No, thank you for sharing your platform.
And being open to learning.
Yeah, and open to learning and sharing it with other people, you know.
Yeah. And it's weird if I show myself as an expert, like what?
No one is.
Okay, that's the Ate Judit.
I think no one is an expert.
Yeah,
no one.
Yeah.
Although I kind of defended Judit also in that aspect, because remember everyone was rooting for Judit, and then there's also a way, but wait, she's a fake ally, and then there's another turnaround, and. Well, I kind of defended her because first, I think she belongs to my to the, we belong to the same generation, and also the intention is good, at least.
Yeah. No, yeah, majority of the allies are like that as well. You know, their intentions are pretty good, but like the execution is different, like bad.
Yeah,
you know, like it's not. As perfect.
But it's problematic. But at least with all her fake ally phrases or slogans, at least she's doing something.
Yeah.
And we actually understood when you were explaining it, when you said, I mean, not you, your character said, you know, I didn't know what I knew now.
Exactly.
So everybody is like that. Everybody seems to be guilty of like that.
I for a great deal also defended her after episode 1 because I knew where she was coming from.
Yeah.
I knew her intentions were good. She just needed some help on how to.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
And who knows? There's no real way of how to. She thought in her mind she was doing it the right way.
There's no manual.
Which is what's special about it.
Yeah.
There's no manual.
As long as she's trying. Yeah, there's no manual.
No matter.
It wasn't taught in schools also.
Right. So that's another problem.
Yeah. Education.
Yeah. Yeah. They don't get scripts.
You know what? I cried when I saw this video on TikTok. Uh-huh. And I don't remember who posted it, but is it on TikTok? But there's this little kid. The kid is 6 years old, and then that kid came out to the parents and said, "I'm gay," and the parents, they welcomed that child, and the uncle who posted it was crying. It's like, well, we're living at this time. You know, what a time to be alive,
yeah,
for children, yeah, to come out bravely and with no fear at all. So,
oh my God,
I think it's starting. It's. I think we're doing something nice.
Yeah. Oh yeah.
I think you know what? It's definitely a difference between the way that, I don't know how you guys came out, but the way that I came out way back in, 150, 60, 70 years ago. But it was completely different because, yeah, it's much, I feel like there's more of an openness, I guess.
Oh, yeah.
I don't know if that's the correct word I'm using rather than before, because back then it was like, who do I, and where, what's the starting point, the process. But nowadays it's like, you have a voice that you can use to speak.
Right. And they have very supportive people also in community.
Yeah. The community is really there. We actually had this conversation a week ago on camera.
Mm.
Guys, we spoke about this, the generational divide. It's easier in a way to come out because you have so much around you, so many resources, and also exposure. Our parents now are seeing more on television. That wasn't there 20 years ago.
There's basically representation now.
Yeah.
The struggles of being a member of the community, and people are aware that this is happening. Because before I was like, what? It's taboo. We don't talk about it. Now it's more out there.
Also, but it's also important to note that the struggle hasn't ended yet.
Oh yeah.
And we're still not yet there.
No.
It would be nice. It would be there. There's still a long road.
You need to check your regional privilege, because luckily for the four of us, we are in countries that support gay marriage.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
But there's so many other more countries that doesn't. So it's also to note that. You need to note that.
I think that was brought up in episode 7.
Yeah.
With at least someone pointed it out, like, you have to check Vlad's privilege.
Yeah.
For him to be able to come out really. Yeah. Mm-hmm. And it's really different from, with the status of Carl.
Mm-hmm.
That's the funny thing about that, though. It's like, we understood where Carl is coming from. And then we understood also where Vlad is coming from.
Yes.
So, somebody's turning red again.
Mark, get it together.
Mark. Anyway, so see, that's what we're at during that time, and I'm like, what is going on? We understand why you want to do this, and we understand why you need to take your time.
Yeah.
So it's like we're like push and pull of our emotions. That's why we're like wrecked during those episodes.
Yeah, me too. You know what? I was crying while reading the script, and they were still editing the script, and I think the episode that I really cried is episode 6, because it was written beautifully. The directions, the ride home segment. It's so beautiful when you read it in the script.
I have a question about that. I have a question about that to you.
Yeah.
Where did Ate Judit drop the poor kid?
Right?
Why did he run all the way?
A car?
Eddie could have taken like
Eddie, can you stop the car?
Okay, if
stop the car.
Because this is Gaya Sa Pelikula. So Judit have to give Vlad that Cameron Diaz moment of running.
Once again, I like things.
I like things.
Yeah.
like that dramatic cinematic run towards a lover.
Because I remember watching that first day, I'm like, what kind of allyship is this? You left him. It's like in the middle of the road and run towards the condo.
Actually, while we were shooting that, I was also like, wait. I could have just asked Eddie, like, Eddie, go back.
Yeah.
And you guys had dinner at the what was it, Judith's house?
Actually, it's supposed to be a restaurant. Yeah.
Restaurant. Okay. I thought it was someone's house. And I was like, they went to somewhere and then she couldn't drop him off back to the... She let him like run from the street towards the condo.
That's once a cinematic scene for Vlad. And also, please don't deprive me of my dream of saying stop the car.
You know what? We love that.
It's a dream came true. Like I like stop the car. I was like
the dramatics of it all. The drama.
No, you actually did that twice. Stop the car, Eddie. Stop the car.
I said.
I said stop the car.
Very alto.
I know.
Feel.
Yeah, and also when you were coming, the pang pangs like, hinatid ka dun sa my car, and then you said, "Let's go, Eddie."
So beautiful. That's beautiful.
Give Eddie a face.
Yeah, a face. Next episode, season two.
Actually, there's another deleted scene.
How?
Because the first time that
to put it out.
No, I think I think they already talked about this. Right after the Maricel Soriano monologue.
Walang magbabagong taon sa
wedding. Yes. So Vlad went with Judit, diba? But actually, Carl even ran. We were about to board the car, and then Carl ran, and he was asking, "Are you going to eat here tonight so I can cook rice?"
What? Oh my god!
Oh, wow!
Why did you guys cut that?
Oh. and what's funny is, him scooping rice is such an important part of the story.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yes.
So that's what it's just been because... elevated. Oh. I'm angry now.
No, but actually, I think they deleted it because it will be shown later on, like when he's scooping the rice and then he remembered. So he put it back. So yeah.
Mm.
Okay. So maybe it's gonna be redundant. I don't know.
Yeah, that's part. Yeah, it is gonna be redundant. Yeah,
it would be because you already asked that, and then
because episode 6 is really long,
right?
And they were actually very worried. They were so worried about episode 6 that it might be dragging. So
One hour, we'll watch it.
Yeah, we'll watch it. Yeah, please.
If I can sit through an hour and a half of each episode, I could have done that.
While and reading also, subtitles for me.
That part.
Yeah.
And we don't really mind, Adrienne. We wake up at 4 a.m. just to watch this when it was... By the way, I'm in L.A., Jericho is in San Francisco.
I'm in San Francisco.
Makoiko is in Auckland, and Nolan is in Cape Town, South Africa. So we have different time zones.
We always go to a Zoom while watching
on our device.
Like, wow!
Yeah.
Oh my god!
Thank you so much.
That's the last series that we've watched that we had to wake up, like set an alarm for it. That's the last. Series.
Yeah. No. That we wanted to wake up for.
Oh yes, that we were willing. We wanted.
Other shows. We said we can watch it later. It's fine.
We try to drag it out. We drag it down. But GSB, no. Mm-mm.
I used to be at work, and I would basically get like someone to come clean my office during that time, so I could escape. So I can escape. I was like, it's GSP time, sorry.
I also remember one time that I forgot to set on my alarm. Jericho was calling me early morning. Yeah, calling me like
it's that important.
3:55 a.m.
It's very urgent.
Yeah, I was like, what? GSP, I'm up.
And then it was in the Zoom, like,
yeah, I'm like, oh god.
Wait, I have a question. So, because you live outside the Philippines, how was it for you for episode 4? Because I used to be an OFW before, and the episode 4 hit me real hard when Vlad was celebrating Christmas all alone by himself. Was it like for you?
Aww. No, because I'm lucky because I'm with my family here.
Yeah.
Ah, okay.
So,
okay.
Yeah, my family's here. So I've, actually, back in college, I was in the Philippines. I studied in the Philippines. So I kind of experienced it a little bit. But the opposite, my family's here and abroad. And then I was there by myself. Well, technically with my sister, but we're alone. Yeah.
Aww.
Yeah.
And then your sister was like, doing missed calls and then you don't answer. Judit.
Lumalabas?
Actually, ako yung Judit eh, kasi ako yung mas matanda. I was the old, I'm the older one. So she's the one who's not answering her
calls. Not answering her calls.
And she had her boyfriend back then, so.
Oh,
checking. It's
not the walls being thin.
It's very thin.
It's you checking now. It's, ooh.
Yeah.
Ooh. Ooh.
No, please don't. Please don't.
Yeah.
Ever. Oh,
Mark.
Okay. We know that you're a good actor.
Slightly.
I mean, to you, what is your greatest achievement when it comes to acting? I mean, I've seen your IMDb. Was it IMDb?
Yep, research.
I saw you. Oh my god, you won the famous award for best supporting actress and nominated for Bliss as well. To me, famous is like I'm geeking out, like famous
Filipino Oscars basically.
Yeah. And I just saw the movies on it and I'm like, oh wait, where can I watch these? You asked us earlier if we've seen Bliss. I've been trying to look
It's on YouTube. I'm not sure.
Is it now?
It's on YouTube. Watch and Talk Weefy and Dog Days. They're also online in MOOVPH, Move PH, Cinema Centenario Online.
We're trying to look for that now.
We are going to find.
Yeah, but we will do a watch.
I'm not sure though if it's available in your country.
Oh, we have VPN.
VPN.
We have VPN.
We're all set up.
So this is the thing about the VPN. Because me and Jericho we're Titos. We don't really know about technology. We don't know VPNs and stuff. So. Makoy Koy and Nolan had one, I think, and they watched GSP on Netflix, and apparently it's very beautiful there. So Nolan gave us the VPN, and we're trying to watch it through Netflix because here in America it's not available, like GSP.
What?
Yeah, it's only in the Philippines.
Well.
Yeah.
I think it's only
it's
in Asia.
It's interesting because. The VPN is like in a different whole new world where I was like, wow, all these like BL shows in Netflix. And I was like, oh, I'm loving every moment of it.
Not really. the VPN made it official.
Right.
Yes.
I cared about Netflix again after VPN.
Right.
Yeah. But yeah.
Okay.
Sorry, I think I kind of answered. I think I kind of answered your. I can't answer your question.
No.
Yeah, actually, your question.
In terms of achievement, because I'm really not into awards.
Yeah.
And all the fame and prestige, and I think as an actor, I think I consider the greatest achievement if the message came across to the audience. And because as actors, I believe that it could be transformational. Yeah, it has a transformative power on being an actor, because you get to inspire, or either inspire or question or demolish all of what you've used to think about, or it could also open up possibilities to you. Like if you do this, if you go to this direction, this will happen to you. If you go through this, this would open up to a lot of so I think the, like for instance with GSP, the fact that people get to share stories, their stories that they couldn't share to anyone,
right?
I think it's already a huge step. And now that even the GSP fans are creating their own communities, like they're very supportive of each other, and then I think that's what I can consider as achievement. And
I'll probably when
we get to learn more about the characters that we're portraying, and even the plights and the issues that were raised, and the fact that we're talking about them, and we get to have this discourse or arguments, and you know, something just keeps on evolving. I think, that's that one.
Yeah.
But of course, I'm grateful for the fans. But thank you.
Thank you.
Yeah. Thank you, Paul.
My question. You spoke about messages and what you want to portray. What is your dream role? It could be either be something that's already existing that you would like to do, or it could be just something that in your mind you would like to play.
Apart from saying stop the car.
Stop the car.
You know what? I actually don't have a particular dream role. Or I just only wish to have a character that's really challenging that I haven't done before. And yeah.
Okay. Something. So what type of character haven't you done before?
Right.
I haven't done yet.
You haven't done yet, yeah.
An old lady or something like that. I haven't done senior citizens role. I would love to.
You can wear my shoes and walk in my shoes. I'm the ancient one here, the old one.
The cat lady.
Oh God! All right. About the dream role that Nolan mentioned, do you have any dream collaboration or with an actor that you idolize or you admire in the industry, local or international?
Cate Blanchett, yes.
Yes, the flavor.
First on the list.
And, Galadriel from Lord of the Rings plus Adrienne.
She has this film. It was shown. It was in an art exhibit. The film is Manifesto, and they collected different types of manifestos, from the Marxist Manifesto to the film Manifesto to the Dadaism, and then Cate Blanchett did 13 or 15 characters all by herself. And then the challenge is turn the manifestos into something else. Like, there's this one manifesto and there were, those are her lines, but they're doing the family prayer before dinner. Or the Dadaism manifesto as a eulogy in a funeral. Something like that.
Yeah.
And she's so good. And it was exhibited in Sydney. My friend were able to experience it because it has different screens, like large screens of different characters. And wow. then at some point of the film, they're all talking at the same time. So it's so good.
I would have loved to see something like that. I would have loved to see that.
How about
manifesto?
It's 13 roles, they say.
How about in local, in the Philippines? Who do you want to have a dream collab or a dream scene with?
You know what? Wait, I already. How come I forgot about it? I was thinking about the other day about that. I wanted to work with this actor. Can I get back to you? Hello.
Yeah. To follow up. Yeah, that's fine.
It's the research.
Yeah.
No, I was like daydreaming of doing a collab, but how come they okay, signs of aging.
not the aging.
Was it a lady or a man? Was it a lady or a man?
I would know.
Wait.
did you tweet about this?
Not yet. Oh, I'm not active on Twitter pala lately.
Yeah, we were.
We're rehearsing. Sorry.
That's fine.
No, you can come back with it. Yeah, we can come back with it.
Yeah. So you were talking about like receiving the Famas Award. You played a role when you received the award. The role was the aunt in Dog Days. How was it playing the aunt?
Actually, the whole experience is really cool because most of my colleagues there are visual artists or musicians, like real musicians. It was only me and Ibes, a real actress, and Barbara. And it was really cool. It's an art house film. And while I was reading the script, like, I want to do this. But I think everything was shot in 1 day or 2 days. The basketball court is a different scene. But most of her, and the lines are really long. And it was exhausting, but it's really cool. It's one of those extraordinary characters that I'm so honored to play, and I had fun with the character. Ate Rochelle. Tita Rochelle.
Yeah,
we'll see once we do the watch party, the four of us.
Ooh.
Yes, definitely. I can't wait to watch
the scheduling of that. Okay.
Yeah, I just saw the chat. I was like, "Whoa, wait, we can watch it, guys. We can watch it."
Okay.
But I had fun also with Doc Miffy, although it was shot only in one evening, the whole evening until sunrise.
Wow.
It was really, but the preparation.
How long is the movie?
Twenty minutes. Oh. It's a short film, it made a huge impact on me, and also with the preparation that I made, because it was a 50s, you know, the 1950s star. Mm. So we had to study how they talk, how they act during that time, and you're inside outfits. The TV television set. The character is still inside the television set. So, and I'm not actually interacting with any actor. I was shot separately.
So it's basically you're monologuing.
Yeah, most of the time. And I couldn't see anyone because I had a glass in front of me as a television screen. So they have to cover everything in black, so it won't reflect on the glass.
Wow!
So, and it was it was my co-actor who actually interacted with the TV, which is pre-recorded, but it the director made it seem like we're interacting at the same time. So yeah, the process is and we were able to go and hike in Bontoc. It's really cool.
All of us here, basically, we love musicals. Like, we love musicals. Like, if given a chance to do any iconic musical role, what would it be and why?
I think I'll go for Avenue Q, Kate Monster.
Why can I see that? It's actually it. My God. Oh my God, that would actually be like, funny.
Yeah, I'm like, it could work. It's so
has
cool.
Rage. She has
the
rage.
Internet is far forward. Are you that?
Yeah. It's such a great musical. Oh my gosh.
It really is.
Yeah.
I'm dead.
Yeah. Thank you.
Okay.
I'm just thinking about it.
But the song there is like the fine, fine line. It's really ouch.
Yeah, no, the music deep. Of that, it's quite a deep musical, even though people don't realize it.
Yeah.
It's covered in fun.
Yeah.
Right.
So, yeah.
And even the everyone is a little bit racist. It takes a huge perspective on how to get along with each other. It's like, why not? Like, can you be a little bit honest with each other?
I think I want to watch it again. just
for that.
Just because. Okay. Adrienne, I heard or we heard that you're an otaku. So, so what anime are you currently obsessed with? And what's your favorite anime and favorite anime character?
Oh no, so many.
You can give us a couple.
Okay. It depends on my mood. So if I want to wreck myself or ruin myself. me and Janice is Evangelion.
Oh.
So Misato, I love Misato and how that's a literally mindfuck anime. But as of now, we're watching AOT, Attack on Titan.
Okay.
Yeah, but yeah, and not until episode 15.
Okay.
But we saw, actually, I haven't finished this yet, this anime series, because we were really savoring every episode. Like, we cannot watch it, we cannot finish one in one go, because it's so beautiful, it's so rich. Look for Mononoke. It's not the Ghibli one. It's an anime during the 90s, I think. Late 90s. Mononoke. And the visual.
Oh, it's a Japanese avant-garde anime.
Yes.
By Toei Animation.
You know the washi tapes? Yes, the visuals, everything, the stories. It's so rich, it's so beautiful, it's so poetic, everything. And yeah, I highly recommend that anime.
I'm gonna put it on my playlist.
It's just so good.
That will be my first anime, BB. You should say this.
Yeah.
I will, yeah. Yeah, because I'm an otaku, but I'm more of the pop otaku kind of. So
I grew up with Naruto. I grew up with Sailor Moon. Ah, Hunter.
Wait, 2011 one or the 1990s?
2011. The Chimera Ant arc. Oh my
God.
No, that is like, what are you talking about?
Exactly. I'm like, okay.
That
no, Naruto is basically my childhood. Yeah.
Yeah.
And but my
he grew up with Naruto, but when they talked about humanity in Hunter x Hunter, and it's not even the humans, you know, tackling about humanity.
The ants were, yeah.
And
right.
the character of Meruem is the best. Oh,
yes.
Yeah, very complex, definitely.
Like so pure and...
Yeah.
But very
okay,
even...
No, I think I found my dream role.
Very well.
Not you being an anime. Not you being an anime.
Not you becoming an ant king or something, or an ant queen.
That's my dream role now. Thank you.
And also with that arc though, just to add, it's also like the political, like the hierarchy of the ants also made it very, very interesting. So
yes.
Yeah. Cool.
Yes. And
stand you even more.
And
stand
of course,
you even more.
Hentai.
You watch hentais?
Of course.
Okay. We said
there's
even
nothing
more,
wrong.
I tell
there's nothing wrong with a little bit of sensuality in there.
I mean,
so you know,
hello.
Throw it in.
You know, it actually hentai makes me turned on more than the actual human beings. I don't know.
Oh, wow. Okay.
Yes.
Is there's like another one? Yaoi. Yaoi's.
Yaoi.
Yaoi's.
Yaoi.
But that's more of like the LGBT, I think.
Yeah. But it's catered to women also, right?
In Japan. I think BL in general is supposed to be catered with
BL in Japan.
And it started in that kind of situation.
That's how it was in the beginning. It was the yaoi's, believe it was like catered by the community, and then they did a live version of it. So that's how it transformed into the actual BL series. So
I think they're the women who likes to watch these. They have a term, fujuis or whatever.
Fuboshi.
Something like that.
Like the diehard yaoi fans.
Yaoi fans, yeah.
But interestingly, so Gege and JP. Actually it was Gege who during the pitch when he said actually I'm not it's not considered BL, but this is actually a queer story.
Yeah.
And for the first time that the LGBT community is represented, and not just to cater to the fantasies of certain groups.
I actually
and
think,
these are really stories from them.
It's called Fujoshi.
The Philippines has done a very good job at moving away from BL to queer stories.
Yeah,
I think that's why we all were so fascinated with the Philippine BLs last year, because they really moved away from the stereotypical BL, which I love.
Yeah,
and now other countries are following the Philippines' example. I'm so grateful.
And all you know, the usual stories of like someone gets, you know, dies of HIV and all
With queer content, it usually is either the very bad or the very good. They don't.
Yeah.
It's but now, Gaya Sa Pelikula was one of the examples where they gave us more than just you're gonna die or you could be happy in the fantasy world. It just gave us more, and I really appreciated that.
And
there's more
about
of
real people, real stories.
Right, real people.
It's the experiences. That's what it was. That created the content in which you know you can relate. It's the
it's very
relatability.
And
even the queer people can fall in love and they can also have love quarrels. it's normal for everyone.
Yes.
Right. That's why I really wanted to have if I'm gonna be like ako masusunod, like I would love to give Sandy more airtime.
Yeah, Tito Sandy. He deserves a story as well.
Like the one that he was talking to Carl at that episode. I think episode 6 was it, where he was.
It was the beginning of eight, guys.
Oh, beginning of eight. Like when you know, like the Charmaine Buencamino comment and stuff.
Yeah.
That wrecked me.
And it was much difficult for the older generations that time, right? To fall in love because, like, parents are really hitting them and
super secret
torturing. Yeah.
Hush, hush. It's the hush, hush. That's what it was. So, currently, are you working on a project? Or are you working on anything at the end of the year? Anything coming up that, you know, we should know?
In 2 weeks' time, on May, actually, I'm directing a play, a full-length play now. The Children's Hour, but it's translated in Filipino. And you know Children's Hour, but you have Audrey Hepburn as the lead. And it was controversial during the 30s because it tackled about lesbianism. And it was the 30s, so it was such a huge thing. And then we adapted it here in the Philippines. And the students are from Philippine High School for the Arts, theater arts major. So they're junior high, and we're doing it live online.
Okay.
Send us the link and we'll watch.
Please. Although expect a lot of glitches because it's live and some regions in the Philippines, they don't have strong Wi-Fi connection because we're all doing it in Zoom, via Zoom, and then we'll stream it on Facebook. But we tried not to make it Zoom-like. We tried to make it as if they're in the same space. So, yeah, and it's a full-length play. It's kind of long, so I'm not sure if people would really watch the whole thing. I hope. But
we'll be there to support.
Thank you so much.
That's exciting.
Yeah, and actually I'm also teaching directing classes to them.
She said education.
Just allied things.
Yeah, just allied things.
They're going to release. We already shot it last February. It's my first title role. Yay! For free for Regal.
Wow.
Online. But I haven't seen it, so I'm not sure if it's. I hope it's good.
I'm pretty sure it's gonna be.
It's by Joey Reyes.
In Tagalog, ikaw pa ba?
Ano ba? Right? Tao din ako.
She's so cute.
No, but it's a different level of type of tao. That's what she is.
You're a goddess.
Yeah.
Alien.
You're a human who ascended to godhood. You're a human who ascended to
Nympha.
Oh gosh. Okay. Speaking of movies, what we'll do is we'll probably just we'll the give you a fire, question, kind of like a rapid fire question, but we'll give it to you one by one. I'm a movie enthusiast. What's your favorite movie, like locally and international, like your most favorite movie? Because we all have favorites.
Oh yeah.
It is one local and one international.
Okay, International Cinema Paradiso.
Oh.
That's on the list.
He's been watch. He's been telling us to watch it.
To watch that.
Yeah,
and it is. It's so amazing when I saw the poster of Cinema Paradiso, the set of GSP. Mm-hmm. It's like, what? Yeah, I had goosebumps. I had a picture with the poster, and locally, I just watched last 2019 Cleaners. It was the best film in 2019. It's a film made in Tuguegarao, and most of the actors are from Tuguegarao. They're non-actors. It's about you know, the cleaners, the cleaners after school. So it's about high school students, and everything per frame. They printed it out on Xerox, and then they highlighted. They used highlighters to color some characters, and then they put it back. They scanned it back to the film, so it's like that. And the story is really good. It's one. Yeah, I'm having goosebumps right now just telling you about that film. I'm not sure yet.
No, because I was trying to Google it. Google is giving me dry cleaners in my area.
No, not dry cleaners. No.
Dry cleaners.
What's the name of the director? Cleaners.
I believe it was Glenn Barrett.
Yes. Barry. Yes. Glenn Barry. And it's his first movie, I think. It's amazing because it's a regional film. So they were saying that, you know,
Were they speaking Tagalog or Ilocano or whatever language?
I think, is it in Ilocano or Tagalog? I'm not sure with the language. Or maybe Ilocano.
Wow,
yeah,
look at that. So, 13 wins and 25 nominations.
It's so good. Wow. It's so good.
I hope you watch it.
It's really good. It's okay. Really good. And it was during the emo years. What year? 2005. It was set there. So the music is also emo-ish. When we watched it in UP Film Center, everyone was singing along with the music, with the songs.
Oh, I love that.
It was so nostalgic for them. It was really good. It's heartwarming. I don't know. I haven't seen a film like that. Especially here in the Philippines. So
Guys,
I highly recommend it.
Add to the cart.
did you see the poster? It's really that. The black and white, and then markers. Like they have the staff were highlighting all of those frames for months, I think. Yes.
Oh my god.
It's so amazing. It's so amazing. And it opened a lot about like regional films can be, you know, they're really great, really great.
Cool.
It's amazing.
Okay.
Yay!
Jericho.
Yes. So speaking of movies, I'm a TV show type of person. So what is your favorite type of TV show? Local and international, if you can choose. Is there one that you're currently watching?
It's so weird because I don't have TV here at home.
But TV's not on the phone.
Right.
Well, I don't have TV. Series, maybe?
Series. Yeah,
if you have a series that you watched.
Okay, the latest that we've watched is Queen's Gambit, right? It's really good.
Oh, okay, from Netflix.
Ooh.
Okay.
And I also love Sex Education.
I love that show.
It's really good. Yeah.
Season 3, is it? Is it going to be season 3 now?
Yeah.
Oh, no. Yeah.
It's supposed to be 3, I think.
Season 2.
It was
season
already
two's done.
Done.
Yeah, season two's done.
Yeah. So it's gonna be
two. Yeah, but yeah.
Yeah.
The way I'm only watching GSP on Netflix. Like
McCoy. McCoy.
After episode 6. Episode 6.
But Queen's Gambit is really good. Like production design wise, the story. It's so
yes. It's really, really it's well made. That's what
yeah,
it's
right.
Well, I was gonna ask a follow up, but I was gonna say, have you watched any other BLs?
Not even Top Locase?
Not yet. I know. Actually, they're all lined up. Like the Itzai, I told Sunset about.
And you know they're having. Season two is coming.
Okay, so yeah, that's already lined up. Na.
We're and basically the same, Adrienne. Don't tell anybody.
No, BP, I'm just don't understand you. Okay.
Wait, is the cherry something?
Cherry Magic, you should watch
cherry
it.
Magic.
Okay, yeah, okay. So yes, it's all lined up. Promise.
Yeah, it's all favorites. Yeah.
The way I've been watching it too.
No, Adrienne, if you want a list, Nolan has one.
Okay.
Jericho.
Can I
debut?
Or Jericho?
Can I add it to countries?
Yeah. So Adrienne, in the last I think month and a half, I've watched over. 30? 40?
Mm-hmm. You've been going.
Yeah,
he did Thailand. Yeah. Well, he's watching all Filipinos. But he did Thailand. Then he did Taiwan, Korea. You're busy with China. You know, he did China already.
Yeah.
And he's back
Taiwan,
in Thailand.
Thailand.
He's back in Thailand. He's just going through it all.
He's digesting
it. I'm so happy.
Wow. Okay, I'll make time for it. It's just that, like, lately, you know, lately, I'm not sure if you also feel it, but there's a New York Post article about this. There's a new kind of feeling, the languishing. Like, when you just feel not motivated to do anything.
Mm-hmm.
It was the past few weeks ago, and when you get up, like, you just feel meh. You're not feeling depressed,
yeah.
But you're not feeling happy. It's just meh.
Meh.
Yeah.
So
it's there. Yeah.
Yeah. So I haven't actually watched any shows lately. And the only thing that's keeping me alive is TikTok.
Same. We can tell.
TikTok. Hours and hours of TikTok.
My TikTok, because I always end up going to bed like 2 a.m.
No, it's a rabbit hole. It's a rabbit hole. Once you start,
when you be on the phone,
it's too easy. That's the problem. It's too easy to find new stuff.
It's already sunrise.
What? It happens. It really happens.
Right, that part.
Okay. So I adore music. Music is my driver.
Oh yeah.
My question is, Gaya Sa Pelikula OST was so amazing.
Yeah.
What song is your favorite from the soundtrack?
Well, whenever I hear the intro of Ride Home, it gives me goosebumps, actually, that one.
That's one is very special.
Yeah, like I want to hold on to that feeling of euphoria. But so, yeah, I have this, but the UDD song. It sums up all the whole story of season one.
Right.
I said that two hours ago.
When we did that
perfect
premiere.
It's just a perfect. It gives you, when you hear it, it gives you all the emotions that you go through.
When you hear that first three notes, it gives you,
Yeah.
And then you just like, and then
it's so good.
It comes rushing in, like, oh.
I love it. Nolan, me and you are like, it's a great driving song.
It's just such a good song.
And especially when you're on the highway. So it just good.
Yeah.
Ooh, I'm gonna use that when I go on my road trip. Just jam out.
By the way, who curated that? Like, who decided on those?
Gege.
Gege was the one who did it. Huh?
It's included in the script.
The mind.
So the mind. when we did the script reading, they were playing this song while we're reciting our lines.
I love that.
Oh wow. Okay. The amount of tea that she's spilling. The amount.
I know. Give me more sugar. Cream.
Actually, it's very similar with the Wattpad. You know, Wattpad style of writing that they include songs and then there's a link going to that song and then you read the chapter. Yeah, I think it's from that.
Okay. So among the group, I'm the foodie. I love food.
Okay.
And my question is regarding food. What is your favorite food and why?
Uh-huh. It's so hard to answer because I love food also. Like I can eat everything.
You know what? Kaya mag-unlock ko sa'yo.
I can unlock with you.
Like
okay, yeah.
Sausage? What?
What kind?
Hungarian? Charot.
Oh.
No. That's why I stan you. That's why I do stan you. That's why you're my goddess. No, and also I believe you're the one who like the pancit canton. Was it you, the pancit canton with cheese?
Oh, yeah.
Yes, with the pancit canton with cheese.
That I never tried it. I need to get some cheese with it.
Yeah, and you can add some mayonnaise also.
Ooh. Oh, I heard about that. It tastes like meso soba dao or like ramen or whatever.
Yeah, and add some nori. It's so good. But cheese with...
The cheese whiz is solid. That thing.
How did you discover that though? Like, did you experiment
it
or
poverty?
No, because that time I don't have any money. I was so hungry and I was PMSing. So I tried everything from my cupboard. Like I love experimenting in my kitchen. So yeah, and it worked. Oh, wow. Yay!
You should copyright that then, apparently, because it's being used everywhere now.
Nice. Okay.
Cool.
Okay, so since you are
sir.
Lumalabas yung accent.
Not that.
His accent comes out.
Oh my god, I have my Australian friend, when he found out, he was like, "Are you mocking my culture?"
It sounded so Australian though.
Especially the sir, like the S-O-R, like sir.
I cannot. Oh my gosh. I can't believe we're at the final question already.
I know, right?
It's been so much fun.
I know.
It has. So
I don't want to ask you. Can I?
What?
I don't want to end this.
Oh, okay. If you're not going to end it, I was going to be like, oh, I want to ask a question.
Go.
I was going to ask you, any hints, wink, wink, with GSP 2? She's not moving. Any information.
She's not moving.
She's not moving. She's not moving. She's not saying anything. I'm looking at her. I'm looking at her.
Oh my god, have you tried Popeyes?
Wait, guys, 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 that's a good answer. So,
yeah, okay.
I am positive. Got it.
Yeah, in our, yeah, in like.
Onion rings, like, the best. When you try onion rings on the gravy, it's the best.
Favorite food, favorite food.
The way our Delulu mind was, like, triggered.
Really? I was like, ooh.
Binalik sa food?
I know. Kaya talaga, guys, talaga maganda ng lugar, Adrienne. Talaga, I love it.
Back to food.
Ay, nako, okay. Si Pao talaga. He loves
Paolo.
Food. Paolo? Yeah. He's a Taurus. Oh. So, yeah. He's eating all the food props and I was like, yes. Yay. During we have a table scene, diba?
The spread. The spread. The amount of
we were
food.
Really eating that that time. Love really that. Trying to finish everything. And the art that was like, no, don't finish everything first, please. We don't have any more food.
Wala nang kanin.
I can't.
Cook rice. I wanna, before my last question, I wanna ask actually, how is it working with those other actors?
They're really amazing. No, they're really amazing. They're so sweet and they're very open. I remember that scene because right after the swimming pool scene, we did the episode one. The first meeting, and then they were really laughing. We had to cut a lot of times, and we extended, so some sequences were moved the other day because of that. We extended because they were really laughing while I'm doing my monologue. It's like stop. But I had fun, especially with Ian, with our scenes together. And also Pao, all of our table scenes, both.
Somebody's
characters.
Turning. Oh my god, somebody's really turning red.
Look at Makoy Koy.
Look at
Makoy
Koy, he's turning red.
Why?
He loves Ian. He loves Ian.
Tell, can, really? if you see Ian, that, can you tell him that?
No.
You know what? Okay, this is really hard for me because we were in the car scene. Actually, it was much longer. They had to edit some scene. You have to cut it back. So the whole time we were talking, so his face is like here, and then I'm just like this close, and it's so hard to concentrate. It's like, what is this boy is good looking? Very tita. And then I had to remind, okay, brother.
Ate ka. Adrienne, ate ka. Ate ka ha, ate ka. Ate ka.
And I think it's a good thing that they deleted that scene because it would look like we're lovers, like so close.
Oh my god.
Mark.
No, but yeah, they're really good. And the lashes of Pao, they're real.
Oh my amazing. God.
That very beautiful.
So amazing.
May ano lang siya sa mata.
Grabe.
Yeah. Although that time, because it's my first time to go out of our house, because it was pandemic.
Pandemic already.
Yeah, I was so scared. I was so nervous. And also with my lines, because all of my lines there are really long.
Yeah.
And they I was there only for 3 days. So I wasn't really eating. I wasn't talking much to my co-actors, except for the last parts, because at least it's their game now. And that's when I started to relax a bit. But yeah, it's really fun. The crying scene of Ian, he was. We did a lot of takes because it has to be in so many angles.
Angles.
But at some point, he was like, He was eating na my hair because it's the first time that I usually di ba ponytail.
Yeah.
And he was crying. I was like, wait lang.
Hilarious.
Oh my gosh.
That crying scene, I hated that. I hated that one.
It's really good.
The way that you,
it's yeah.
Good. It was the way that you grabbed him.
Yeah.
I actually got carried away from that scene. It to have him like firsthand. So it's so painful. It's really painful. I remember I cried in the restroom after the scene with Paolo. Like when he walked out. It was so painful that I had to lock in the shower just to let it off. Because I tried my best not to let the tears go down, to appear more, to appear strong in front of the other people. But I couldn't take it. Afterwards, like,
oh my god, it's so powerful.
Episode 7.
Mark, eight. Time.
It's time, Mark.
It's time.
Oh, yeah.
Okay. Being a theater actor, what would you advise a young person wanting to pursue their dream of being a theater actor as well?
Okay. At this time now of pandemic.
In general,
if you wanted it, yeah.
Okay, because most of the people are saying that theater is dying and all that shit because they only refer to theater with the building itself, but it's actually not, and theater keeps on evolving. You know, when you're an actor, actually even not in theater, even in films or TV, or when you work with communities, you can start from, you know, any age. And there's no retirement age in acting because there's always a character that can suit you. It's really a matter of dedication and how you're willing to stay and to learn and to be more open. And it's really up to you if you really love it. Because, of course, it's challenging, especially now that we cannot interact intimately, but you know, you really have to know yourself first, what you really want, and stay with it and stick to it, and you know, with full conviction that you have to declare that this is what you want and this is what you want to go. It's hard, it's really hard, but and every day you have to choose it. You have to choose what you love doing because, you know, in work, we do, even in theater, it can be depressing at times or very challenging. But at least you love what you're doing. Instead of stressing on something and really don't like what you're doing, that's the worst.
I felt that in my bones.
Take that. Carl's dad on the series, take that. Because we were going to fight the dad because he was sitting on his dream. He's like, showbiz? Walang
future.
No. Like, kailangan bang maging masaya? Something like that for the work that you're going. You have to.
Yeah.
You have to be happy with what you're going to be doing.
Mm-mm. Although sometimes, because I posted this on TikTok and I shared, one producer from Singapore told me, like, if you just do what you do just for the money and then you'll be miserable, but if you do what you love doing, the money will chase after you, something like that. And then someone commented, like, it reeks of privilege, and I was like, actually, it's not. It's not just privilege. Like, if you really love what you're doing,
you're gonna work hard for it.
There's no privilege or there's nothing.
Yeah.
I mean, I know a lot of actors that, you know, with no, not from the privileged background, but they're really good. And then they soar, they're soaring. So yeah, push for it. Push for what you really love them. And then after knowing yourself, make sure that you share it to other people. And it's only not, you're not doing it just for yourself, own gratification or you know, but it's meant to be shared by everyone. And I think it during this time where I consider it, it's a dark time, a very, very dark time for all of us. This is where we're needed the most.
Yeah.
Because you know, about when you talk about the humanity and our shared values, and it's being trampled on every day. And I think we need to step up and we need to fight for it. And yeah. And not being messianic about it, but I think it's our duty as human beings to be, you know, to be kind and all those stuff. Yeah.
That's why we stand you, Adrienne. Thanks for coming.
And Miss Universe goes to
and I thank you.
just crown her.
Adrienne, thank you very much for accepting our invitation.
This was lovely.
This is really lovely.
Thank you so
and
much.
We love you even more.
I love you too so
you.
Much.
Thank you so much.
It's as if we've known each other for so long.
I know. Well, I can tell people now that I know Adrienne personally.
Yep.
Well, how come we're not drinking here?
Oh,
it's
season two.
Yeah, my water. Season two. Wink, wink. Season two.
Is it Titos?
Too big.
Actually, too big. Kami. We're very old now.
Yeah. We go for water now. We don't go for alcohol.
Yeah.
Guys, no. Nice. Pineapple juice, Lula.
Oh, I have that in the fridge.
Oh.
I cannot. Oh, this is amazing and lovely.
Well, again, Adrienne, it's very lovely to see you. We're really happy that you accepted this. We love you.
Thank you so much.
We hope to see more of you coming up a couple of months and whatnot. And we're there to support you.
Thank you so much.
Well, that was so much fun. We laughed so much. Oh my goodness. And the tea were spilled.
We want to thank everyone for listening. We hope you enjoyed learning more about Adrienne.
Well, if you have not do watch Gaya Sa Pelikula and Bliss on YouTube, to see the wonderful Miss Adrienne Vergara, aka Ate Judit.
Do not forget to follow the Titos on wherever you are listening to. And also follow us on Twitter and subscribe to our YouTube channel for more amazing content coming up soon.
All right. Also, if you wanna find out who she wants to collab with, watch the vidcast a week after or so when we post this podcast. All right. Until next time. Goodbye, everyone.
Bye, y'all.
Bye.
Season finale.
Season finale.